Hello everyone. Today our topic in discrete math course is the propositional logic. The rules of logic give you precise meaning to mathematical statements. These rules are used to distinguish between valid and invalid mathematical arguments. Because a major goal of this course is to teach students how to understand and how to construct correct mathematical arguments, we begin our study of discrete mathematics with an introduction to logic. Besides the importance of logic in understanding mathematical reasoning, logic has numerous applications to computer science. These rules are used in design of computer circuits, the construction of computer programs, the verification of correctness of programs, and in many other ways. A proposition is a declarative sentence, that is, a sentence that declares a fact, that is either true or false, but not both. Propositions are the basic building blocks of logic. The area of logic that deals with propositions is called the propositional calculus or propositional logic. For example, all the following declarative sentences are propositions. Amman is the capital of Jordan. 2 + 3 = 5. 2 + 6 = 7. Propositions 1 and 2 are true, whereas proposition 3 is false. And for example, the following sentences are not propositions. How are you? This sentence is not a proposition because it's not declarative. X + 1 = 2. This sentence is not a proposition because it's neither true or false. It can be turned into a proposition if we assign value to the variable x. For example, if x = 3, 3 + 1 = 2 becomes a proposition and its value is false. Letters are used to denote propositional variables. The most common used letters are B, Q, R, S, etc. The truth value of a proposition is true, denoted by capital T, if it's a true proposition, and the truth value of a proposition is false, denoted by capital F, if it's a false proposition. Many mathematical statements are constructed by combining one or more propositions. New propositions, called compound propositions, are formed from existing propositions using logical operators. Next, we'll define some of these operators. Let B be a proposition. The negation of B, denoted by negation of B, not B, is this statement. It's not the case that B. The proposition is read as not B. The truth value of the negation of B, not B, is the opposite of the truth value of B. In the truth table, B can be false or true. If B is false, not B is true, and if B is true, not B is false. The negation operator constructs a new proposition from a single existing proposition. For example, if we have the proposition, Alice's car is new, its negation is, it's not the case that Alice's car is new, or we can express it more simply as, Alice's car is not new. The negation operator operates on a single proposition. Next, we'll define two propositions that operate on more than one proposition. Let B and Q be propositions. The conjunction of B and Q, denoted by B conjunction Q or B and Q, is the proposition B and Q. The conjunction B and Q is true when both B and Q are true and is false otherwise. A conjunction is a compound statement formed by joining two statements with the connector AND. To obtain the truth table for conjunction of two propositions, we have four states, 2^2. They are true, 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 false, false, true, false, false. The conjunction B and Q is true only if both the propositions are true. Otherwise, it is false. This truth table is the same as the truth table for AND operation. If you have three propositions, then the number of states is 8, and the conjunction of the three propositions is true only in the case if all the propositions are true. Otherwise, it will be false. Next, disjunction. Let B and Q be propositions. The disjunction of B and Q, denoted by B disjunction Q, is the proposition B or Q. the disjunction B or Q is false when both B and Q are false, and this is true otherwise. Here we have the truth table for disjunction of two propositions. True or true, true, true or false, true, false or true, true, false or false, false. If you have more than two propositions, you can construct the truth table in the same manner. The disjunction will be true if any of the propositions is true, and it's false only in the case where all the propositions are false. Next, we move to examples. Determine the truth value of these statements. -6 greater than -3, conjunction square root of 3 less than 2. The first proposition is false. Square root of 3 is less than 2. The second proposition is true. False, conjunction true equals false. In the second example, the first proposition, -1 to the power 4 less than 0. -1 to the power 4 is 1. 1 is not less than 0, so this proposition is false. Disjunction, sine of 30, assuming 30 is in degrees, equals to 1/2. 1/2 multiplied by 1/2, 1/4, and this is less than 1/2. So this proposition is true. And the final result, false, disjunction true equals true. Example 2. The statement 5 is greater than square root of 17 and 3 cubed is less than 25 can be expressed as 5 greater than square root of 17. Since here we have and, we use conjunction operator, 3 cubed less than 25. To evaluate this compound proposition, 5 greater than 17 is true, conjunction 3 to the power 3, 27 less than 25, false. A true conjunction false equals to false. And the statement, 5 is greater than the square root of 17 or 3 cubed is less than 25 can be expressed as the proposition 5 greater than square root of 17. Here we have or, so we use the disjunction operator. 3 cubed less than 25. The first proposition is true, disjunction. The second proposition is false. True disjunction false equals to true. Next example, construct the truth table for the following logic statements. B conjunction not Q. Here we have two propositions, B and Q. So in the truth table, we have four states. True, 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 false, false, true, true, true. To find the compound proposition, we first find not Q, which is false, true, false, true. Now B conjunction not Q. True conjunction false, false. True conjunction true, true. False conjunction false, false. False conjunction true, false. In part B, the compound proposition is B, disjunction, Q, conjunction, not R. We have three propositions, so in the truth table, we'll have 2 to the power 3, which is 8 entries. We list all the possible states of these propositions, false, 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 true, etc., true, true, true. To find the compound proposition, we first find not R, which is true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. Next to Q, conjunction not R. False conjunction true, false, false conjunction false, false, true conjunction true, true, true conjunction false, false, false conjunction true, false, false conjunction false, false, true conjunction true, true, and finally true conjunction false, false. Next B, disjunction Q, conjunction natar. False or false. False. False or false. Here false. False or true. True. False or false. False. True or false. True. True or false here. True as well. True. And finally, true. Disjunction false. True. Next example. Given the following propositions, B, Selma is clever. Q, Selma is not beautiful. Translate the following compound proposition to English sentence. B, conjunction not Q. In B, we have Selma is clever, conjunction and, not Q, Selma is beautiful. Next example. Given the following propositions, P, the number 17 is prime. This proposition is true. Q, the number 18 is odd. This proposition is false. R, the number 23 is prime. And this proposition is true. For each conjunction below, write a sentence and indicate if it's true or false. B, conjunction Q, the number 17 is prime and the number 18 is odd. B, conjunction Q, since B is true, conjunction, and Q is false, then this compound proposition is false. B, conjunction R, the number 17 is prime and the number 23 is prime. Here we have a true, conjunction true, which is true. Q, conjunction R, the number 18 is odd and the number 23 is prime. False, conjunction true, results in false. Next example, let B, Q, and R represent the following statements. B, Selma submitted her assignment this morning. Q, Ali wrote a letter to his father. R, Rami went to the cinema yesterday. Write each of these statements in symbolic form. A, Selma submitted her assignment this morning and Ali wrote a letter to his father. So we'll have B, conjunction Q. Ali did not write a letter to his father. We'll have not Q. And Rami went to the cinema yesterday. Conjunction R. Selma did not submit her assignment this morning. So we'll have not B. Or Ali did not write a letter to his father. Disjunction not Q. Either Ali wrote a letter to his father or Rami went to the cinema yesterday, but not both. First, we have Q, disjunction regarding Rami, R, but not both. Conjunction, Q, conjunction, R, or not. And the last example for today, rewrite the following expression as conjunction. Really, any an inequality can be expressed as a conjunction. A less than or equal to X, which in turn less than or equal to 9. We can express this inequality as conjunction as follows. X greater than or equal to 8, conjunction X less than or equal to 9. For today, that's all. Thank you.